videos for class 8 social science, and we're going to discuss about the minerals resources, isn't it? So in the previous video we have already started with the chapter. So in that video we have discussed about the classification of minerals, what is minerals, isn't it, different methods of extracting minerals and all, right? So now in this video we're going to discuss about the distribution of minerals in the world and India, right? So now let's talk about the distribution in the world first. So as we know that minerals, it varies from place to place, isn't it? As in all over the world, isn't it? The rocks are not similar, isn't it? There are different types of rocks forming in different regions, isn't it? So because of that, we're going to find the different types of minerals in different regions, isn't it? So some areas, they might have a huge quantity, some might have a less quantity, okay, right? So now because of that, there is a huge uneven distribution of minerals all over the world, right? So if you take about the world, isn't it? So first one, let's discuss about the iron. Talk about your iron, okay? So since iron is used for making metals and steels and all, okay? So the main iron ore are your hematite, magnetite and hematite, okay? So among them, your hematite contains a huge amount of iron, right? So iron is mixed with the other substances to form a steel, right? So your leading producer of iron ore in the world is your China and India, right? So now let's talk about the copper, okay? So copper, it is a good conductivity, isn't it? So it is usually used in electrical factories or industries and all, okay, for making electrical wire and appliances and all, okay, right? So next, the leading producer of copper, copper is Chile and Peru. So that this region is the one is the leading producer. So next is about your bauxite, right? So bauxite, it is a light material, okay, light mineral. So it is an ore of your aluminium. And basically it is used for making aircraft, right? Since it is a very light mineral, right? So the main leading producer of bauxite is your Australia, right? Manganese, okay, so manganese is used for making steel, okay, and some kind of alloy product. Apart from that, it is also used for making bleaching powder, electric batteries, glasses, tiles, etc., right? So the leading producer of manganese is your China, right? So next is your gold, platinum and diamond, okay? So since it is a very precious mineral, it's used for making jewelry and all, right? And plus it is an exchange item also, right? So it is exchanged with the other countries or a foreign item, isn't it? So it is found in Africa, okay? A large producer of gold and platinum and all, right? So last one is your tin, okay? So tin is used for making your steel, okay? And plus apart from that, it is also used for making cane, okay, which is used for preserving food, right? So the leading producer of your tin is Brazil and Bolivia, okay? So this is the whole distribution of mineral all over the world. Let's talk about the distribution of minerals in India, okay? So India, if you know India, okay, India is a leading producer of mica, okay, and a great exporter, okay. So it is a leading producer and exporter of mica. So apart from that, we are going to find in the other regions, so they are going to find various minerals are found, okay. Since we know that in our India also, the places or the climatic condition or the rocks are found in the variety, isn't it? So they are not similar. We can say in this region only we are going to find the minerals. No, isn't it? So it has been unevenly distributed. So some of the minerals as I have written out here, like for the first one is iron. Okay, so iron is mostly found in Chhattisgarh. Your Chhattisgarh, okay, then Odisha and Jharkhand. So this region is the one you could find iron. Okay. Next, copper. Okay, copper is found in Chhattisgarh, then Rajasthan, right, and Madhya Pradesh and Jharkhand. So this is the area. Okay, this is the region where you're going to find the copper. Copper. Then next is bauxite. Okay, bauxite is found in Odisha, then Chhattisgarh, okay, then Jharkhand. So this region is the one where you're going to find the bauxite. Next, your manganese. Your manganese you're going to find in Odisha, then Madhya Pradesh, okay, then Maharashtra. So this are the three regions where you're going to find manganese. Next, your gold. Okay, gold is found in Jharkhand, and last one, tin is found in Chhattisgarh. So these are the reason where you are going to find the varieties of minerals in all over the world, sorry, all in our India, isn't it? So you can check out, so mostly plagiarism is the one you are going to find the varieties of minerals, and as we know that plagiarism is also considered as a house of minerals, right? Minerals, okay, so let's understand why we have to conserve the minerals and how we can conserve the minerals, okay? So let's talk about why then, okay? Since we know that the population is increasing day by day, isn't it? So the demand of the people is also increasing side by side, isn't it? So in order to fulfill the demand of the people, right, so there is a great extraction or huge amount of extraction going on all over the world, isn't it? So whatever minerals is present in the world is becoming less, isn't it? Since we know that this all minerals are exhaustible, isn't it? They cannot be regenerated again, isn't it? If they have to regenerate, they will take a long time, millions and years is required to form a new minerals, isn't it? So, and plus the people, they are extracting the minerals wherever they find them, isn't it? So they, the region is not preferable, isn't it? They just try to extract the minerals to fulfill the demand, isn't that the thing? So now, because of that, whatever, there is a great damage going on all over the world, isn't it? Obviously, it is damaging the environment, okay? Plus, the ecosystem is also becoming imbalanced, isn't it? Yes? So, the animals, the flora and fauna, obviously, they are being affected, isn't it? And indirectly, you can say even the human beings are also being affected, right? So, if the minerals, the uses of minerals is not being controlled, then in the future, then the generation, okay, they will not going to. They will be the sufferer, okay? They will be deprived, isn't it? So, in order to sustain the minerals, okay, we should find out some of the new solution in order to conserve the minerals. Okay, so here are some of the list, okay, how we can conserve. The first one is improves the technique of extraction and purification. So, the technology has been so much advanced, okay, so we can utilize those technology to extract a new way extracting, okay, and how to purify the minerals and all, okay. Next, metals such as iron, gold, silver should be recycled if possible, okay. So the minerals metals such as your iron, gold, okay, that if possible, okay, if you require find any other alternative solution, okay, then we can recycle these metals, okay. So next is minerals should be saved, mines should be saved from collapsing, okay. So we have found in many regions, so once they are drilled or they are going to extract the minerals, okay, the land is just been left over, isn't it? So after you can see the collapsing of the land, okay. So now next is the alternative resources should be used. Yes, we can, instead of using only the minerals, okay, those minerals which is present, okay, so we can use find out the other alternative resources also, okay, which we can replace these minerals, okay, so that it can be saved for the upcoming generations. So this is all about the mineral resources and all, okay. So this is all about the chapter. Hope you have understood. Thank you.